Hello and welcome, friends. Today I want to talk to you about, what do you do if there's roots in your sewer line? How bad can it be? How expensive is it going to be? I'm sure you're asking a ton of questions. You might have gotten to this channel because maybe you have roots in your sewer line. Maybe you had a clog. Maybe somebody came over to fix whatever that clog was. And that's when you found out that you have roots. So let's get into it. So roots, right? Those are the devil's playthings. They seem to work their way into just about everything. They can tear up asphalt. They can tear up concrete. They can get into your sewer line and they can cause some problems, right? They can get in there. They can cause blockages. They can cause sewage to back up into your home. They can cause all sorts of problems. Even, consider this, they can contaminate your drinking water, right? So hear me out. If you have a sewer line that has roots coming into it, that means that sewer line's compromised, meaning the water's able to escape out of that sewer line and into the surrounding soil. Well, let's just say, for sake of argument, that you happen to have an older home where that sewer line runs close to the well, right? Well, let's say that sewer line's leaking. Guess what? Now it's getting into your drinking water. And that can be a problem. You don't want to do that, right? So roots obviously come from plants and vegetation. So the best way to figure out whether or not you potentially have some root issues is when you look at the house, right? Where does the sewer line exit? Let's just say, for sake of argument, that we have a property, right, that has a forest in the backyard, nothing up front. The sewer line just so happens to go out the back of the house and into the forest and down into the gully where the public sewer line is, right? Well, if you have that kind of setup, what'll happen is now you've got all of those trees, plus the grass, bushes, or any other type of vegetation that's gonna be sitting right on top of that sewer line. So as that wastewater goes out of the back of the house, down the street, basically into the back of the woods, you run the risk of every single joint having a potential root intrusion point, right? So the most common times that you'll find root intrusion is gonna be on Orangeburg pipe or terracotta pipe. Those are the old style of piping, right? You can find it on cast iron pipe. It's just not quite as common, right? So generally cast iron pipes, you're more likely to run into issues of collapses or clogs or more things like that, not necessarily roots. It can happen, just like it can happen with PVC, it's just not as common, right? But for this argument, let's just say we have a 1920s home, right? So here in Baltimore, almost every single house that's a row home in the city is gonna have cast iron pipe in the foundation. As soon as it gets to the foundation wall, it almost every single time transitions to terracotta unless that pipe's been replaced. Well, the terracotta sections generally would only be a couple feet in length, and then they would put another section, and then they would put another section, etc. Those terracotta pipes, how they're joined, is going to be basically a bell shape that fits on top of the end part of the other pipe. And then, of course, they would seal it, and then they would bury it. Now, terracotta pipe, as we all know, it's just clay, right? It's just like a what you'd see on a flower pot. So that pipe's incredibly smooth and it is resistant to clogs or things getting hung up. However, it's not super strong, right? So if over time, let's just say you're building a fence and you auger through it, or let's just say you put a little bit too much weight on there, you do run the risk of that pipe potentially collapsing. You also have the risk of that seal failing. And when that seal fails, that's where we run into our problems of roots. So as the roots work in, it'll almost every single time be right at the joint from where one pipe starts to the next pipe. It can happen to where if something like cracks or breaks in the middle section, the roots can get in, but it'll almost always be right where the pipes join. So now we've covered types of pipe, right? We've got our terracotta, we've got our Orangeburg. Orangeburg's a pipe that if you ever see, you just want to get rid of it. It's just terrible stuff, right? So now we want to talk about, how do you deal with this? So there's a couple trains of thought, right? You can try to chemically address the situation, you can physically address the situation, or you can kind of do a mixture of both. So let's kind of get into what the first one is, right? So if you wanted to chemically treat for this, you can put a product into your sewer line, generally through the toilet, that will kill off the roots in the pipe, right? So like something like a copper sulfate will be used to kill off the roots. I have never had very much success with that particular product, but there are people that I know in this industry who say that that works great and they're usually able to kill off all those roots and have no problems down the road. It can potentially kill the trees, but that's beyond my scope of expertise, right? So you can chemically attempt to treat for the roots. Again, I've not had very much success with this, so I generally would prefer to go towards the physically getting rid of them or mechanically getting rid of them, however you decide to do it, right? So depending on how aggressive these roots are, kind of depends on your strategy of attack. So the first way that you could do it is you could get a physical auger bit and you can chew right through those roots, depending on how thick they are and how big they are, right? Now, that won't solve for those roots coming back in. So if you were to snake out those roots and just rip them out, yes, you would clear the blockage. However, those roots will come back. Now, it might take 2 years, it might take three, it could even take 10. However, I have had plenty of houses where they just keep doing it, and then after 5 years, it seems like now they're doing it every year, and then 7 more years go after that. Now it seems like they're doing it every 6 months. Those roots will start to grow back faster and faster and faster. So if you're gonna go down that route, best idea is probably to get rid of those roots, right? Use the auger, and then get rid of the source of the roots. Now, that's the complicated part. It's really hard to tell whose roots are they. Is it the tree to the left? Is it the tree to the right? Is it the tree right on top? Where are those roots coming from? And that's where it can be complicated, right? So if you get rid of it and you don't replace the pipe, now you gotta start considering, do I just chop down all of the vegetation that's over my sewer line and hope that that addresses the root situation? I would say most times that's usually what most homeowners will do, but the permanent solution to consider would be to replace the pipe. Now, that's probably the answer nobody wants to hear, but PVC is very resilient and really good. When you join those pipes together, you're just basically melting the PVC onto the coupling, and it goes on to the next pipe, and it just keeps doing that over and over every 10 to 20 foot, depending on what type of pipe the person's using. So by having that solvent weld, you're creating, as long as you use the correct kind of glue and the primer and you do everything the way you're supposed to, you're basically creating a non-permeable surface for those roots to get in. The odds of the roots getting in through a PVC coupling and the pipe itself is very limited, unless you just happen to do a bad job backfilling and you crush the pipe, right? At that point, then you're kind of SOL and you gotta start over. So if you've chemically tried to treat, you might have some success, not a whole lot. I don't necessarily recommend it, but you can try it, right? Physically getting rid of the roots is a good option. And then the most dramatic option is to replace the entire section of pipe. Now, a third kind of meh option that you could consider is you could try and jet the lines, right? I generally will recommend jetting when it comes towards getting rid of physical debris like sludge buildup or grease buildup or something to that effect. You can jet and that can work, and that can rip up a lot of the roots. It just kind of depends on how big they are and where they're coming from. Now, the same issue with just physically augering through is that you're not fixing how the roots got into the pipe. You're just kind of getting rid of the evidence of those roots in the pipe. So it doesn't really solve your problem. My opinion, the most reasonable thing to do would be to replace the pipes, that way you don't have to deal with that problem ever again. So generally, if I ever see any pipe that is terracotta or Orangeburg, I will usually say hey, look, here's the issues that you could run into. You should consider going down the route of replacement. Whereas with PVC pipe and cast iron, I'm perfectly fine with cast iron as long as it looks okay. It is metal, so eventually it will rot out. But it is, in my opinion, a better pipe material than terracotta or Orangeburg pipe is, right? So I hope this was helpful, but I do want to make sure that I stress enough that if you know your sewer line's going through your house, out the front, back, side, wherever it's going, don't plant something over there, right? Use your brain. If you know your sewer line's going out the back of the house and you want to do an orchard, put the orchard further away from the sewer. Put the orchard in the front. Put the trees away from the sewer or the septic system for that matter. And usually you'll have a better chance and better time, right? If you found this interesting or useful, please hit that like button, subscribe. I have more information posted every day on the world of well and septic. I'm here to help us all grow as a community. So if you've ever run into this problem before, leave a comment below. Tell us about your story. Tell us how much did it cost you to do this? And what did you run into while you were doing this? Maybe you got something that somebody else is going through right now, and you'll be able to help them out with that process by sharing your experience. So I hope you found it interesting. I look forward to talking to you guys soon in the comments. Till next time, guys.